Mr. Chairman, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. As a developing country and a tropical island nation, Sri Lanka is highly exposed to the impact of climate change. We consider that transfer of technology to developing countries will ensure that people will be able to address the need of adaptation and nationally suitable mitigation actions. Even though our per capita emission is low and insignificant in the global sense, we have contributed and will contribute to global mitigation efforts. On the domestic front, I am glad to declare that Sri Lanka has launched several climate smart initiatives. We recognize the historic initiative of Malta in 1988, which led to the launching of the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. Sri Lanka has communicated our intended nationally determined contributions to the UNFCCC as part of the upcoming climate agreement. It is necessary to have deep cuts in global greenhouse gas emissions by the developed countries considering the historical responsibility. Sri Lankan delegation looks forward to the success of COP21 in Paris and to have agreement on an extended, legally binding climate agreement with deep emission cut to mitigate the greenhouse gas and to reduce the global warming and unprecedented climate change impact. In conclusion, Mr. Chairman, as a Buddhist, I strongly believe that Gautama, the Buddha, was the greatest environmentalist who was born to this world. Lord Buddha was first visionary to speak about the concept of sustainable development. On behalf of my delegation, I wish to thank the organization for the kind hospitality and helping to make this event a success. Thank you.